Welcome everyone, and thank you for joining us for our Harlow College Open event. I'm Paul, I work for marketing, and I'll be overseeing this open event today. And also in the background is my colleague Jasmine, who will be helping me with that. Now, delivering the open event today will be Selena Avery and Della Gregory from the Supported Studies team. How this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them alongside any information they wish to share on screen. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you. However, you will be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this will be at the bottom of your screen. If you're using a mobile device, simply tap the screen and this will appear at the top. And someone will either answer your questions live or answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask your questions as we go along, and we'll save some time at the end of the presentation to answer as many as we can live. Now, please be aware that your name will appear next to your question, but you can click Ask Anonymously. And we are recording this webinar, and you will receive an email with a link to the recording. This will also be available on the Harlow College website. Now, firstly, we're going to share a short video with you just to show you around our campus and introduce you to the college. You'll also hear from the principal, Karen Spencer.
Hi, I'm Karen Spencer and I'm the principal at both Harlow College and Stansted Airport College. It's a pleasure to welcome you to our virtual open event. We're really sorry we can't see you in person, but this is an opportunity for you to have a look around and ask some questions. We've got lots of teams talking to you this evening about the fabulous resources and facilities we have here at the college. They're also going to tell you a little bit about why you should choose Harlow College. Please take time to look around, ask questions, and we hope to see you in person in the near future.
I hope that's given you a little flavour of life at Harlow College. I'm now going to hand you over to Selena to begin the presentation. And don't forget, send in your questions using the Q&A feature.
Hello, and a very, very warm welcome to Supported Studies. As Paul has said, my name is Selena Avery, and I'm the manager of the department. We're very, very proud to be part of a very progressive and busy college, as you will have seen from the slides. And that does give some fantastic opportunities for our learners within the context and the safety of supported studies. Next slide, please. So within supported studies, we have quite a wide and varied programme. We work to the preparing for adulthood agenda. So we're a non-accredited area. So in the main, students do not take formal qualifications, but it's all about increasing their independence, their skills for life and their opportunities for working, going into a work environment at a later date. So we have some different groups. Our first group that the majority of our students will come into would be towards independence and work. So the towards independence and work group is a really wonderful opportunity, usually for students that have come straight from school, so sort of around 16 years old. They've come in and it's a good chance for them to get used to being in a busy college. It's a big busy college, and as I say, within supported studies, it's a very supportive environment. It's a chance to build on their social skills, their communication skills, start to get into the college way of life, a little bit of independence. We cover lots of different areas. So we cover, within the preparing for adulthood agenda, we cover health and well-being, employability skills. We look at English and maths as well. I'm going to go into this in a little bit more detail shortly. And there's also opportunities for work experience as well. The Links Plus course is sort of the next step along for a lot of our students, but for some students, they may come in at that level if they've perhaps been at a sixth form somewhere else, and they're ready to do some little bit more work focused things, and maybe sort of also maybe looking at other courses within the college. So Links Plus will offer them the chance to do some little bit more work experience, but also might offer them the chance to have some tasters around different areas of the college if they perhaps think they might like to move on to a level one or level two course, depending on their abilities within the college. But perhaps they're not too sure what they want to do, so we have that opportunity for them to have some tasters with the support of our staff as well. Links to work is quite similar, so there's still the opportunities for work experience, but the focus within Links to Work is generally that they will be moving on to our InterWork programme, which is a supported internship programme. And Della's going to tell you about that in a moment. Within supported studies, however, please do ring, have a chat with me about what's best for your young person, because we are very, very good at bespoking our programme and trying to make them fit the individual. So, you know, we do have lots of students that will follow the main group that they're in, but they will then also do some other bits and bobs that are really just unique to them. So, you know, do have a chat with me about that if that's something that you think would suit your young person. So I'm going to hand you over now just to Della Gregory, who's going to tell you a little bit more about the InterWork programme.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Della, and I'm one of the employment coaches for the InterWork programme. Can we have the next slide, please? So the main aim of the supported internship stroke sort of like into work program, it's all about preparing young people ready for the workplace. Yeah. So this is done by a number of different things. So some of it will be classroom based. Yeah. Obviously, some of it will be out in the work placement. So in the classroom, we'll be covering things like how to complete a CV, completing mock interviews. We'd be looking at work placement expectations. It would involve travel training. And as and when the work placements come up, then the students will then have the opportunity to build on their employment skills in a practical environment within the workplace. Yeah. So obviously the main aim is to get students out in the workplace as soon as possible. Yeah. And we will work in partnership with employers and with the young person and with parents and carers. And prior for them to be coming onto the course, we would ask them to complete a vocational profile, which would give us an idea of some of the areas of interest for the young person, which enables us to start approaching companies on their behalf. Job coaching. So once a student has a placement, for the first 3 months, they are accompanied by a job coach who will go into the workplace with them, make sure they're settled, make sure they understand the expectations, guide them through and support them with any new activities and skills that they need to actually develop. Once they hit the 3-month stage, we start to look at maybe pulling some of that support away and letting them become a little bit more independent. And eventually, when the student is ready, yeah, they are actually then going into the workplace on their own. Now, this differs with every student. So it may be that we pull the support away at 3 months, but then the job role slightly changes and we may have to go back in and support them on a full-term basis again. So it's very, very flexible. We have a very good success rate. So 75 to 82% of our students have actually gained paid employment. And some of the companies that we've actually been working with is Princess Alexandra Hospital, National Express, Nando's, Sainsbury's, and a number of local companies as well. Prior to the current situation we are in, we are actually working alongside Manchester Airport Group and hope to pick that up when business is back to normal up at the airport, which will open a vast amount of new opportunities for our students. So as Selena mentioned before, a bespoke program is able to support the individual. So this may mean that, you know, the work placement may require them 4 days a week and they may only attend college 1 day. Yeah, they may want to sort of like, you know, do some additional voluntary work. So again, the whole course can be very, very flexible to support the individual. Thank you. I'm going to pass you back to Selena now.
Thank you, Della. Could I have the next slide, please? So many of our learners, as Della has said, progress into paid employment once they've worked through our programme, and it's really great to see those successes. And others have moved on to a mainstream course within the college after building their confidence through trying out tasters with support from our team. So quite understandably, a lot of the time when students join us, they don't know what they want to do in the future. So we like to think that we offer a nice wide variety of different experiences for them while they're with us and try and just tap into their interests and their abilities to try and sort of help them to progress into what they may want to do, be that in the workplace, through work experience, or through mainstream courses in the college. Other managers in the other areas of the college are very supportive, you know, and we would have, so for example, we've had people go across to hairdressing and beauty and maybe gone to those practical sessions, maybe a morning, and they have a support worker go with them so they feel quite comfortable and try things out. We've had students have gone to motor vehicles as well. We've had bricklayers, business. So you name it, we've tried quite a lot of different areas within the college. So that's really, really nice for a lot of our students to be able to do that. We've also worked with other areas in the college for sort of after school clubs and things as well. And that's been really successful because it's nice for the students from our area to be able to, you know, mix with other people within the college, meet other people and sort of be quite inspired sometimes by what other learners within the college are doing as well. Next slide, please. So the course content, which is the same across all of the courses that we do, apart from probably the interwork programme, which is slightly different, as Stella's explained. For all the courses, they will do English and maths. That's non-accredited, so we actually call it problem solving and communication skills, because basically it's skills for life. It's English and maths skills for everyday life. We do have quite a few students, for example, that perhaps need some help with their money skills. They might need help with their time, telling the time, sort of budgeting skills, things like that. And for English, you know, maybe basic letter writing, putting a CV together, just practicing those punctuation skills as well, so they can put a good piece of writing together. So we concentrate on that. That's not to say there isn't the opportunity for qualifications. If your young person gains a GCSE level 3 in their English or maths, then they will automatically have the opportunity to come to college and to work towards a grade 4 as part of their programme. And again, this will be done with the mainstream, but with support from our area as well. Some students like to continue with their more formal English and maths, and we can arrange functional skills for them as well. And again, that would be a bespoke part of their programme, as the main part of the programme would be to do the non-accredited work. So that's something that you would discuss with us. All the students work on their employment skills to sort of a little bit more gently and towards independence and work, and then, you know, a little bit more skills as they work their way through our programme. So with the employment skills, we do things like we do sort of interview skills, thinking about sort of all the individual skills that they might need in employment, and skills that they already have as well, and working on those. During this very unusual time where we've had to do some online learning, we've been doing interview skills online, which is something that sort of after this is sort of going to be happening a little bit more and more. So that's been quite nice to sort of do that with the students as well. We have health and wellbeing sessions, which is basically health and wellbeing for them, for life, for independence, working on sort of we have our own kitchen, so we do some healthy eating sort of cooking skills. And with cooking, they don't just come in and it's all there ready for them. With cooking, they need to decide what they want to cook. They need to plan it. We go to the shops and get the shopping for it. We budget for it. They'll come back and make it. And maybe bring you something tasty home, we'll see. Lots of work experience opportunities. We go to Harlow Town Park. Most groups will go there for part of their programme, for sort of usually a day, where we have been involved in Harlow Town Park now for about 4 years, and we've been sort of helping, and we've contributed to the Green Flag Award that they've won every year, and that's been really nice. We walk across there, it's a bit of teamwork while we're there, and the students do really enjoy it, particularly in the summer. We go to Royal Gunpowder Mills. We have work experience opportunities through Rainbow Services, where we've been involved with different projects with the elderly in Harlow, sort of cafe projects, things like that. There's a really big wide variety of work experience that we're normally able to offer. We have an IT skills course, which is part of the programme. Again, that's sort of improving their IT skills and doing some little sort of different things that they may not have done before, sort of animations and things like that, which they really enjoy. And all students that come to Harlow College will have an iPad that they use for their work. And these are used daily in the classroom for different things. We have an art and design session each week, which is in the main, it's producing art and design products for our shop called In The Making, which you'll see a photo of shortly, and that's over in the Harvey Centre, so do go and have a look at that if you're not aware of that at the moment. Obviously closed at the moment and under refurbishment, so if you look through the windows and it looks a bit of a mess, please don't be too horrified, it will be back to normal soon. And then we have sport and yoga sessions. We go across to the leisure zone. We have a lady who comes and does yoga with our students, and some of the students are, oh, I don't want to do yoga, but it's actually kind of grows on them, and it's a really nice, peaceful thing that they're able to do, and we have seen a lot of the students get a lot more supple as time's gone on, so it's just another sort of a well-being opportunity for them. Next slide, please. So a typical day, every day within supported studies is different. We do try to learn both inside and outside the classroom. We enjoy lots of activities and trips. As I said before, many of our learners have their own bespoke timetable, which is suited to their goals and interests. As the manager of the department, I like to always sort of be looking out for different opportunities of things that we can be doing. And the team as well, they always say, oh, I've just seen this. Do you think the students would like this? And we try to incorporate things into what we do if we feel it's going to be beneficial and enjoyable for the students. We're quite lucky that we can be flexible because, as I say, it's a non-accredited program. So as long as those that are doing any sort of qualifications are able to still do those, we can bespoke what we're doing around any opportunities that come up. The day starts at 9:30 and finishes at 3. For the majority of our programmes, that's Monday to Friday, with the interwork programme is 3 days a week in college until their work experience or their placement starts, and then that will be a bit more flexible. We generally have an hour for lunch, and during that hour the learners do take their lunch in the refectory with the rest of the college, but it's very heavily supported. The support workers are out there amongst them keeping an eye, and we find that that works really well. We also have clubs and activities across the lunch break, as well as at the end of the day as well, usually till about 4:15. Okay, next slide, please. So this is Lula. So this is our supported studies therapy dog. She is still only just 1 year old. And as you can imagine, her first year as being a therapy dog, has been a bit of a up and down one, really, because she's been in and then she's been out. So but she's a very good natured dog, and she's brought lots of joy to a lot for students. We will speak to a young person to ensure that they are okay with dogs. If they're not, then we do keep her well away, so please don't have any worries on that score. But then on the other side of the coin as well, if your student, your young person likes dogs, it's a really nice nice addition to our team. And she's ready to go for a walk. Very handy if we've got any students that are perhaps a little bit upset or want to talk something through. They go for a walk with Lula and perhaps their key worker, and I don't know, the world seems a better place. And she's all ready to go to the town park with the students as well when we start doing our work experience back over there. Next slide, please. So lots of work experience opportunities. I have just mentioned some of them. And it's nice to be able to do that work experience in a supportive environment with some support workers, key workers with them as well. We have our own shop, as I mentioned, called In The Making in the Harvey Centre. And when it's up and running, it's a great place for them to practice those customer service skills and also learn about all other aspects of running a shop. We have a lovely lady, Jo, who runs the shop and manages the shop. And she's very keen that the students do learn everything about running a shop. So literally even down to cleaning up and dusting the shelves and having a sweep around and cashing up the tills, you know, all those money skills can be practiced, and it helps to build confidence with a lot of the students. And then also within that shop, they can actually be making things as well while they're actually on site there. So it gives a little bit of a different aspect. Rather than being in college all the time, they might be out in the shop doing some work as well. And as I mentioned before, some other outdoor placements that we have, the Royal Gunpowder Mills, Harlow Town Park, and Epping along the railway. That's quite a popular one as well, and quite a new venture for us that we've been doing. Next slide, please. So there's a little picture of In the Making. That was a little while ago when we first opened. So do go and take a look. Once you hear that the non-essential shops are open again, please do take a visit. It's on the first floor of the Harvey Centre. And we do also have a Facebook page and Instagram account for it as well, which you can connect to from the Harlow College website. Next slide, please. So some examples of students' work, just to give you a little bit of a flavour. It's a shame that you can't come and visit. So just thought we'd put a few photos in. So on the left there, that's one of our outdoor activities, helping out there. I believe that is at the town park. And then the middle photo, that's our lovely big room that we have within supported studies. Which, as you can see, they're doing some yoga there. Most of them are doing some yoga. Just worth a mention as well, just off of that room, we have a lovely sensory room as well, with bean bags, coloured lights, and we can dim the lights in there. And that's just a really lovely place for students to go. If they are feeling a bit overwhelmed, if they need 5 minutes, they can go and sit in the sensory room, either with or without some support, just to sort of get themselves together before going back perhaps into class. And then on the right there, you've got the kitchen. We are fundraising at the moment for souping the kitchen up a little bit, because it's quite old, but it's functional, but we would like to make it more of a homely atmosphere, so that when students do cook a meal, perhaps they can invite their parents in to come and share the meal with them, or they at least can sit down together and eat their meal together in a nicer sort of atmosphere. So we've been busy fundraising for that, and we're doing quite well prior to COVID, so we'll pick that up again when we all come back. Next slide, please. Just a little bit more. So on the left there, that was a science club that we did. So we do tend to tap in to the skills of the staff within the department. We've got 23 staff in our team. So there's lots of skills there. And this was, we had a lovely lady with us who was qualified scientist. So she did a little bit of a science club, and we used the science labs in the college. So we do have, you know, we can use the facilities in the college sort of right across the board, really, if we want to do different things. And then the other slide there is a little bit of a team building activity that we did, because as I say, we do like to be up and about and not just sitting in the classroom all the time. Next slide, please. So course costs, generally we don't ask for some courses will ask for costs at the start when on enrolment. We generally don't ask for any money on enrolment. We do have lots of trips and visits throughout the year, but we do try to keep the costs down. We do have a minibus, so there's no charge for travel if we go somewhere in the minibus. If we do have anything where a cost is involved, we do let you know well in advance. But say many of our trips don't carry a charge, or it might be that it's just public transport. So as you can see, the boys on the left there went to London with Della, I believe, on the tube. And some of them had never been on the tube before. So it's things like that, you know, building those, just making the world a little bit of a bigger place sometimes. And then on the right there, you've got the Harlow Playhouse, where we go to the pantomime every year when we can. Obviously, we missed it this year, but that's always a huge success, and it's quite a nice thing to do in that final week before Christmas. Next slide, please. So student support. So within supported studies, we are a great support network. You'll find that the staff are really good at communicating with you. And sort of, if likewise, if you've got any questions or queries, you will have a key people that you contact. Your young person will have a learner mentor, which is their teacher really in the class, and they will also have a key worker, which is one of the support workers. And generally, we try to match them up and see how, sort of like the first couple of weeks when the students start, we'll sort of see how everybody gets on, and it's quite nice to kind of match a student to a key worker that they actually feel that they can talk to and come to if they've got any worries or concerns. But also the wider perspective, we have the STAR agency in the college. They'll help with the careers advice, work experience, and financial support and bursary as well. You'll receive information through to do with bursary, and if you do qualify, you'll be able to fill out the appropriate forms in order to give you a little bit more support with financial side of things while your young person's in college. Okay, and then the learning support, there will always be support for your young person within supported studies. It is very well supported. Next slide, please. Okay, so if you haven't done so already, you can apply online through the college website. So if you apply online, and then that will then generate an interview, so you'll have a chance to have a proper chat with myself and another member of the team, and ask any questions. And then we'll explain sort of the process to you as well. Generally, most of our students within supported studies would either have an EHCP or would be high needs funded. So we can talk that through with you at interview as well. Okay, so thank you. Next slide, please. Okay, so I'm just going to have a look to see if we've got any more questions. That's all I've got for today. So let's just have a look, see what questions we had. I'll just run through them with you. Okay, so what kinds of work experience can the student obtain? So as I've mentioned, we've got lots and lots of different work experience. So for the students that are in Towards Independence, Links Plus and Links to Work, generally we do ask the students what their interests are and what they might like to do. But we're forever finding new opportunities. And as Stella's put here, we've got Harlow Town Park, which is generally all of our students will do that at some point. We've got Plant Pots and Wellies, which again is a gardening community project, and that's literally just at the back of the college. We've got the shop in the making shop, and there's always been lots of new opportunities. So as I say, we work very closely with Rainbow Services, and they will come up with a whole array of different opportunities. So we had a couple of students went to, obviously not this Christmas, just gone the Christmas before, went to help out with Christmas parties for some community groups in Harlow. And that was a lovely thing to do. They got a Christmas lunch and everything, and they were dancing with everybody and just things like that. So lots and lots of various, all sorts of different things that come up. And say a lot of sort of maybe cafe type work as well, a bit of retail in other opportunities, not just in the making. And please, you know, if your young person comes to us, please do let us know if you know of any opportunities, and because we're always looking for more things. So just to go back up to the top as well, the progression routes. So generally the majority of our students will either go the into work route and gain a supported internship. They have to be really work ready for that. So if your young person is coming straight from maybe from sixth form, we will sort of have a really good chat with them just to make sure that they are ready to move into that. Generally, we will put them on Links Plus program first of all, before moving them on. And then we do have some learners that will come to us just for maybe 1 year to get them used to college, get them settled in, and then ready to go into mainstream in their second year. Okay. So the therapy dog, we've heard about your therapy dog. How does that work? So therapy dog, as I said, Lula, she was being trained by canine assisted learning. That's now ceased. She's had her first year of training. It was unfortunate that it was, I don't know if it was off-site, but we need to get her back into the swing of things. So she'll be coming back onto college campus, and very excited to see all the students again. And she'll be starting to, she was a puppy, she's older, she'll be starting to do sort of more interaction with the students in class. But as I stressed before, it will be if the students want her to, so please don't worry on that score. My son has already applied for a level 2 mainstream course and has a conditional offer. Do we need to apply for supported studies separately so he can attend with you for the other days? Okay, I don't know if I've spoken to you already who sent this message, but if you haven't spoken to me about that, then I would suggest that you contact me via admissions, and I'll ring you and have a chat with you individually about that. Okay. How do you use iPads in sessions? iPads are used quite a lot in sessions. So we will do, a lot of their work is actually put onto what we call Shobi. So they might do a piece of work in class and then they might take a photo of it and load it onto Shobi. So it's always kept on there. Something very, very simple that for those of you that are new to the college, that I think is really useful with the iPads, and it's a very simple thing. Lots of parents, they might say when their young person comes home, "Oh, what did you do at college today?" And they were like, "Oh, can't remember," or something like that. What we do is we encourage them to take photos of what they're doing. So they could show you a photo. And we had one young lady who didn't really used to talk very much at all when she got home, and she was taking photos of her time at the town park. And then that opened up those conversations, and it was really nice for the family to be able to see what she'd been doing as well. So that's a very simple thing that we use that I think is really useful. They'll use them for research. They'll use them for, we do quizzes, interactive quizzes, which are great fun, Kahoot, which helps to test their learning, what they've actually done. And I think, you know, a lot of the time we like to not use them sometimes as well, so that they're not always on the iPad. You know, we like to be out and about too. So it's been very useful during the COVID time, so for these online sessions, because they've all been quite used to using them. And how do you apply? You apply online, through the college website. So you need to go to supported studies, and then I would say in the first instance apply for towards independence and work, if you're not sure, and then at interview we'll always discuss that, and if we feel that your young person should perhaps be on Links Plus or Links to Work, then we'll talk that through. Just to say as well that when the student starts, during those first 6 weeks, we sometimes have a thing called, we call it movers and shakers, where we might just see, you know, if they're happy in that group, if they're suited to that group, or if they may be better sort of on another programme like Links Plus or Links to Work. But that will all be discussed with you and your young person before any decisions are made. Okay, so thank you for coming on this evening. I hope that's been helpful. I can't see any further questions.
Selena, sorry, there is one there. It actually says, can supported studies be taken alongside a mainstream course?
Yes, I believe I asked the
person to give you a call, wasn't it?
To contact admissions, and then okay. pass pass the details through, and I'll contact them, have a chat about that. Yeah. Okay. All right, so I think we'll hand you back to Paul now, and thank you for attending this evening.
Okay, well, thank you for joining us today. We hope you got a lot out of the open event. And just to say, our online applications are now open, so please head over to our website and you can apply online today. We'll drop you an email with this session recording, and we'd really appreciate if you could just spend a couple of minutes filling out our survey, just so we can continue to improve this service. Don't forget, you can also download our brand new prospectus. It's gone completely digital this year. It's jam-packed with information, videos, virtual tours. And you can download and view our prospectus on our website. We're going to keep this session open just for a couple more minutes in case there are any last minute questions you'd like to ask over our panelists. And you can do that through the Q&A feed, as I say. So if there's anything else that you'd like to ask, we're going to stay live for a few more minutes. And thank you very much, everybody. Thanks for attending, and we hope you have a great evening.